أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حامدا ومصليا ومسلما أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. صدق الله العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد مبارك وسلم وصلي عليه. صلاة وسلام عليك سيدي يا رسول الله، صلاة وسلام عليك سيدي يا حبيب الله. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما ابدا على حبيبك خير خلق كلهم محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من رب ومن جميع. منزه عن شريك في محاسنه، فجوهر الحسن فيه غير منقسم. ثم الرضا عن ابي بكر وعن عمر وعن علي وعن عثمان ذي الكرم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما ابدا على حبيبك خير خلق كلهم. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, jalla jalaluhu wa amma nawaluhu wa azama shanuhu wa jalla majduhu wa la ilaha ghayru. Countless salutations be upon our holy prophet Imam al-Awwaleen wa al-Akhireen, Qaidul Mursaleen, Sayyidul Nabiyeen, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa Ahmad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Honorable Ulama-i Kiram, in particular His Eminence Peer-e Tariqat, Rehber-e Shariat, the founder of Darul Uloom Misbahul Quran, Sahib Zada Misbahul Malik Lukmanwi Sahib Maddasilluhu, and from Luton our guest Mohsin-e Ahle Sunnat, Sabka Amir Jamaat-e Ahle Sunnat Britannia, Haste Allama Kari Halil Ahmed Haqqani Sahib Damat Barakatum Laliya Wal Qudsiya, and the beloved Hafiz Sahib. I'm not familiar with the name. These are honorable ulama who are present in this gathering, respectable followers of Ahl Sunnati wa Jamaat, devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Today's host, Brother Abdul Shakur Sahib. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his humble effort in the court of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. I have been here since 1:30 because I have to go down south, so the time that's remaining before I commence another journey, I will share with you the sayings of the Quran al-Kareem and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in light of Miladun Nabi. Say Subhanallah. If you look in the country that we live in, everything, they have a way of measuring. And when they talk about listening, those, whether they in profession, whether they are civil engineers, doctors, or whether they work for any financial institution, you will realize, as these brothers will confirm, that whenever they give you, you're doing your training, college, university, there are levels of listening. They have measuring, they have ways of measuring how effective one is listening. So for worldly means, the non-Muslims, they have their levels. They have a level one. And what is that level? They give an example. Because this, alhamdulillah, I do a job, a profession, duty separate to my duties as a Muslim. So I am familiar with both, and that's why I want to share with you. Why? Because if I don't give you a practical example, you will come here and your listening will remain at level one. We don't want your listening to be at level one, we want it to be at level three. The definition they give of level one is that when you go for shopping and you're in a lift and somebody comes is with you, he talks to you, engages with you, and you listen to him, but you are ignoring him because you physically are present, but your heart, your mind is elsewhere. That is level one. Level two of listening is when you are there, but you're paying attention to them half-heartedly. But level three is that when you're listening, but in the mefil of Milad, in the court of Muhammadur Rasulullah, when one recites the Holy Quran, recites the Hadith, the sayings of Muhammadur Rasulullah,
then you are in Walsall, but your heart is in Madina Al Munawwara. So these are the levels. Why is it the Ahl Sunnati wa Jamaat of Walsall have many masks, but it's the deviants, the misguided, who are leading at the forefront. They have schools for girls, for boys. Where is the Ahl Sunnati wa Jamaat? Where are you? This is the way I preach according to my teachers and my shiur. Why? What's the point coming here and you don't have a benefit? Do we want Walsall to remain as it is? We want change. Our elders are not going to give change because they laid the foundations and the mosque that we have today. But it is to you youngsters to change the direction of your heart towards Madina Al-Munawwara. And then your mosques and your houses will be fulfilled with the love of Rasulullah alayhi salam. This is the message. Hazrat Sahib is here. He's more learned than me. With in his presence and making him as a witness. These are issues which are faced by not only Walsall, but the whole of the Muslim community, not just in the United Kingdom, but wherever the Ahl Sunnati wa Jamaat are, we are failing in our mission. Our mission is to spread the love of Muhammad Rasulullah. But how can we achieve this mission when we with one another, we are giving a shiddawa ala kufar. We are being so stern on one another that when we go to a non-Muslim, we act that we are so pious. Yet in our own household, in our mosques, we go against the teachings of Muhammad Rasulullah. This is not a message of Islam. But if these messages are not addressed, these issues are not addressed, then how will change come about? Change will come when your heart is purified with the remembrance of Rasulullah. And then you will not think of a nightclub. You will think of Gumbad al-Hazra. You don't want to be in the company of a female who is forbidden for you. Why do you fall into this trap? Because Satan, the topic that I wanted to discuss, I don't have time to even begin that. Never mind conclude it, I don't have time to even commence it. This is why whatever I think is appropriate for you brothers who are here, I am addressing you. We have two elders who are addressing the Urdu language. I am here for you. Say it louder. Now let's come. That when these issues are facing us, we look at beauty, shaitan, Satan. There are two powers in this world. One is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla shanuhu. The other force is Satan. Satan. Iblis. So which path are we going on? We are saying we are Muslims. We believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe in His unification that He is the creator. Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. We believe that He has power over everything. Yet we are following the way of Satan. Why is this? Let me tell you. This is falsehood. This is materialistic belief that you possess today. That when you look at a female, you think that is beauty. Because Satan leads you to misguidance. But you want to talk about beauty? You want to talk about beauty? لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. You want to talk about beauty? Let's come in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh believers, I have done a favor upon you. That is بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. That from amongst you, I have sent my messenger. Don't think I'm shouting. These are my beliefs. This is my passion. This is my beliefs. This is my iman. And I'm here to address you. So now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Let's come in the court of Ghazali Azama. Imam Ahl Sunnah. Alama Sayyid Sayyid Ahmed Kazmi Shah Sahib Rahimahumullah Ta'ala. He writes a book, Al-Haqq Al-Mubin, in the Urdu language. And he states, I will do a definition of that to save time. He states that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He beautified His internal and external with eternal beauty. حسن الامدود اللہ تعالیٰ نے جب اپنے محبوب کو جلوہ گر کیا آج یہ بچے کلبوں میں جاتے ہیں اسی لڑکی کے پیچھے بھاگتے ہیں یہ حسن ہے اوئے او کیا حسن ہے حسن تو یہ ہے کہ جب رب نے اپنے محبوب کو محبوس فرمایا تو اپنے حسن الامدود کی تجلیات عطا فرمائی اور جہاں حسن تو نہ صرف اپنے حسن لامحدود کی تجلیات عطا فرمائیں بلکہ اپنے معرفت کا نور بھی عطا فرمایا You want to gain close proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then come in the court of Muhammad Rasulullah مَنْ يُقِئِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَلَتَا اللَّهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says obedience to Muhammad Rasulullah following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without any condition complete obedience اب محمد رسول اللہ من يطیر رسولا فقد اطاع اللہ is obedience to Allah سبحانہ وتعالی امام اہل سنت فاضل و محدث بریلوی امام عشقاں امام الشیخ احمد رضا عبد مصطفی رحمہم اللہ تعالی This is what he states about beauty. وَحُسْنِ قَمَالِ حَضُورِ ہیں کہ گُمَانِ نَقْسِ جَحَانَ نَحِن He says even that thinking cannot be well up that any fault you can link towards the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم such is his beauty and he has been beautified by eternal beauty and Imam Ahmad رضا said وَحُسْنِ قَمَالِ حَضُورِ ہیں کہ گُمَانِ نَقْسِ جَحَانَ نَحِن The point that I want to address here, Imam Ahmad Raza rahimahullah ta'ala is mentioning that look at the beauty of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never mind there being a possibility of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam having any error in his characteristics. He says such thinking cannot develop. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has beautified the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with eternal beauty. And as a direct result, this thinking, this ideology cannot give birth, cannot come into existence. That's how much purity Muhammad Rasulullah has. That's the excellence, the magnificence, the uniqueness. In creation of Muhammad Rasulullah. Now let's come to the second point. This was an issue. It still remains an issue. But I have given you a direction. And that direction, when you come in the company of the ulama, will not mislead you. It will not take you to Najd. It will not take you to Tehran. It will take you to Baghdad in the court of Ghawsul Azam. It will take you into the court of Khawaja Karib Nawaz Mohiuddin Chishti Ajmeri. It will take you to Imam Bahuddin Naqshband, Imam Shahbuddin Sohrawardi. And many of you are from Midbar. It will take you into the court of Peer Shah Ghazi, of Mia Muhammad Baksh. اور پیر سے یہ نیک عالم شاہ تو ٹیکنگ جو کوت ہے امام احمد رضا بریلوی اور امام ربانی مجدد علیہ السانی شیخ احمد فاروقی سرہندی اور تاجدار گولرا مہر علی محدث علی پوری جماعت علی and then two in the court of امام الاسد پیر سید جلال الدین شاہ and then the court which I have just come from he is the kutub of his time Kutub of his time. People call Multan Madinatul Awliya, and that is correct. That is the city of Awliya. But where I have been, that is also Madinatul Awliya. I have been in the court of Sher Rabbani, Mia Sher Muhammad Shakpuri Rahimahumullah Ta'ala, the Qutb of his time. And you know what he did? We talk about humans. He used to sit and do the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a jungle. Animals, dogs, etc. They used to come and sit around to listen to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now look at the state of the Muslims, and we do not even do what the dogs did in the company of the awliya. It's a moment of reflection. But let's come in the corner of Sher Rabbani. It's still time. But you have to speak the truth. Not everybody does that. Why? If somebody tells you a mistake, that person will think, if I say this to him, he won't call me again. But we say, to hell with such mentality. Because we are not here in your court. We are in the court of Muhammad Rasulullah. He is our leader. And he is our guide. The guide of humanity. The mercy for mankind. The path which leads to the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Sher Rabbani, dogs come. He gives them food. You know the Ashab-e Kahf, he will change his form to enter paradise. Why am I mentioning this to you? If non-humans can benefit from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the remembrance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why is it that we cannot benefit? Not just for one moment. You're sitting here for 2 hours, 3 hours, and you say, Alhamdulillah, I am in the court of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you leave this house, why am I mentioning it? Are there no other Sunni houses in Walsall? There are. But today, the remembrance of Muhammad Rasulullah is in this house. So you're mentioning this house, number 56. So now, I don't want you to live in falsehood. You come here and then you leave. Look at the levels of listening I told you. Why did I tell you them? Why? So you can concentrate on yourself and judge what position you are in. Ahle Sunnah wa Jama'ah. Do you know the belief of the Ahle Sunnah wa Jama'ah? Open Fiqh Al-Akbar, Imam Asam, Imam Abu Hanifa, and Imam Sabir, rahimahumullah ta'ala. Read Imam Fakhruddin Razi, rahimahumullah ta'ala. Read Imam Taqiyuddin Subki, rahimahumullah ta'ala. He mentioned the Ahle Sunnah. We are on the middle path. We do not say that we will only be punished in the grave. We are fearful of the punishment in the grave. But we are also in anticipation of the arrival of Muhammad Rasulullah in the grave. Arshe haq hai masnad rifat Rasulullah ki. Dekhni hai hashr mein izzat Rasulullah ki. قبر میں لہرائیں گے تا حشر چشم نور کے جلوہ فرما ہوگی جب طلعت رسول اللہ کی اور لا رب العرش جس کو جو ملا ان سے ملا بٹتی ہے گونین میں نعمت رسول اللہ کی so elevated is the prophet's seat so you can understand so elevated is the prophet's seat that the highest heaven is beneath his feet.
Subhanallah.
He said, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now look. This is why I'm addressing you. If you are understanding, and if you're listening with your heart, with the ears of your heart, because the Sufiya also, they're present. So if you come, this was the message of Miladun Nabi, because it's past 2:30, and I had to leave. But before I leave, I want to give you a message in the month of Ghosul Azam. Qutb-e Rubbani, Mehboob-e Subhani, Ghosul Samdani, Shabaz-e Lamakani, Ghosul Qawnain wa Ghosul Saqalain, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Al-Hasani Wal-Husayni, Waliye Baghdad radiyallahu ta'ala an. Say Subhanallah. If I was listening to you, if I took put on board, how you are replying, then I, you wouldn't be able to hear me. I said to you, we're in the court of Muhammad Rasulullah. Is this how you're going to sit there? Angels are in this gathering. They're saying these Muslims are also. Say Subhanallah. Louder. Shall I wake you up? Let's come in the court of Imam Ahmad Raza. What is the wazifa of the Ahl Sunnati wa Jamaat? He says, Gaz mein jal jaye bedino ke dil. Ya Rasulullah ki kasrat kijiye. Nara Risala. Nara Risala. Say something at least. So I can understand and comprehend that you are understanding me. Let's come in the bargah of Ghawsul Aazam. The verse. With begins with laqad manna Allahu ala al-mu'minin. Within that verse, the ulama know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as wa yuzakkihim, as the one who purifies. Now let's come to purification. The purification of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that he is muzakki. He not himself, he not only himself is purified, but whoever comes in his company, whether it is Abu Bakr, Umar, Usman, or Khaydar, whether it is Talha, Zubair, Ibn Abbas, Abdullah, Ibn Masud, or whether, say louder, or whether you see Hazrat Qibla, he's the Khulafa of Nariya Sharif, Khaja Qasim Marwi Rahimahumullah Ta'ala, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beautifies him, he becomes Khawaja Khawaj Khan. And then through his disciples, today we see Luqman Musa. Why am I giving this example? To show to you that this spiritual benefit, this purification of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam exists today also. And we have Mashaykh, alhamdulillah. But let me tell you now, in the court of Ghawsul Aazam radiallahu ta'ala an, he talks about the inner self. I talked about Sharia. Now we are talking about Tariqat. Sharia is the call, is the saying of Muhammad Rasulullah. Tariqat is laqad kana lakum fi Rasulillahi uswatun hasana. It's about coloring yourself, beautifying yourself in the company of the ulama, beautifying yourself with the teachings, with the sunnah, the methodology of Muhammad Rasulullah. Now, let's come to Ghawsul Aazam radiallahu ta'ala an, bearing the time in mind, in Fatwa al-Ghaib Sharif he mentions that you have Nafsi Amara. Nafsi Amara is that stage when one's inner self, when one is engaged in sin continuously, all bad deeds, no good deeds. This is Nafse Amara. Many of us are in this state, yet we don't even know the name. Now do you see why I'm addressing? Why I am talking on this topic? That is Nafse Amara. After Nafse Amara, Nafse Lawama. Nafse Lawama is a state when you do both. When you do sin, but you also rectify by doing repentance in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then from Nafse Lawama to Nafse Mutmainna, now your inner self is sacrificed on the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now whatever, when you talk the truth. Now when you walk towards the mosque, not the nightclub. So the Nafse Amara's definition is that you go towards Broad Street. But Nafse Mutmainna is when you walk towards the court of Muhammad Rasulullah. Now you are walking in the streets of Madina al-Munawwara. Mutmainna. From Mutmainna to Fana. Fana is when you come and you buy out the hand of a sheikh who is Sahih al-Aqidah, who Imam Ahmad Raza rahimahumullah states about. There are four signs, four qualities of a sheikh, of a peer, of a murshid. He must be Sahih al-Aqidah. His spiritual lineage must go to Muhammad Rasulullah. He, number three, he must have knowledge. Number four, he cannot be a fasiq. He cannot be an open sinner. Alhamdulillah, we have Anwar Shariat in front. He's like an open book. This is for your confidence. But now let's come from Mutmainna to Fana. Fana is that state. These are all stations that one can achieve himself. You can achieve these stations yourself. We come to how after this. Then when you come to Fana, you come to Fana. Here, everything, all your movements of your body, everything, your own will, everything you are sacrificing, not just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for His servants also. This is the maqam of Fana. What is the difference between Mutmainna and Fana? When you become steadfast and Mutmainna, then through that steadfastness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla shanuhu gives you such spiritual elevation. Then now you come to the station of Fana. And when you come to the station of Fana, reading Salah is not a burden. Doing ablution is not a burden. Walking through the mosque is not a burden. Listening to your parents is not a burden. Following the ulama is not a burden. Sacrificing your wealth for Islam is not a burden. So you are in the station of Fana. This is Fana. From Fana. For Hazrat Sahab, I say this. Then you go to Baqa. Baqa is that station that you cannot achieve yourself. And those who read Baqa, Ghose Azam states, Akhadami ala nuki rijali. My foot is on the men. And from men it refers to the only Allah. Is on the neck of all the only Allah. Akhadami ala nuki rijali. Say subhanallah. So this is Baqa. And the station of Baqa is higher than Fana. But let's get beyond Namara.
Subhanallah.
So concentrate on Amara. Let Bapa Hazar continue or finish. From Fana, Amar Nafse Amara, Nafse Lawama, Nafse Mutmainna, Fana, Baka, Lika, Badal, Kutar, Kutar, Ghos. These are the stations of the Awliya. Some are Kutubul Aktab, some are Ghosul Azam. So these are spiritual journeys and the station and the elevation and the status of the awliya after the Prophet ﷺ has gone from this mundane world. After 1500 years, we still have people who are fana, who are in the station of Baqa, in the station of Lika, in the station of Badal and Qutab and Ghos. But you need a spiritual vision. What is the spiritual vision? Ahle nazar ki aankh ka tara Ali. Ahle nazar ki aankh ka tara Ali. Ahle wafa ke dil ka sahara Ali. Mawla Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, ana madinatul ilmi wa aliyum babuha. I am the city of knowledge. Ali is its door. You want to gain spiritual elevation? Whether you are Naqshbandi like Hazrat, you have to come to the door of Mawla Ali. But when you come to the door of Mawla Ali, then you inherit the Aqidah of Mawla Ali. And what is his Aqidah? Hayru hazihi li ba'di nabi. Hayru hazihi li ba'di nabiyya Abu Bakr wa Umar. This is for Hazrat. Hazrat Mawla Kainat says after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most superior is Abu Bakr and Umar. Why? Hawaja Ghulam Mohiuddin Ghaznavi to Hawaja Qasim Morvi. Where do they end up through Salman Farsi? In the court of Baad Zambia. Ashraful Bashar bi Tahqiq. Khalifatul Rasul. Who is Abu Bakr? Khilafat mein Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Rafaqat mein Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Khidmat mein Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Jihad mein Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Nabi ke baad ummat mein Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Masallai Rasul pe Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Ghar mein Abbal Sadiqe Akbar. Mere Kareem Aqa Alaihi Salam farmate hain, Ama innaka ya Abu Bakr Abbalu mein yadhulul jannata min ummati. Oh Abu Bakr, sun lo. سب سے پہلے تم میری امت میں سے جنت میں جاؤ گے جنت میں افضل صدیق اکبر then you're sitting in the presence of my shaykh who belong to the Naqshbandi order Alhamdulillah my spiritual connection through Sher-e Rabbani rahimahumullah ta'ala Sisla in Naqshbandiya and through my shaykh bin Sayyid al-Fansham Mashhadi ayyadahu allahu bin asayhi in 1989 from bin Sayyid Yusuf Gilani rahimahumullah ta'ala he got Khilafat from Baghdad Sharif so I am a dog of the Sisla in Naqshbandiya and Qadiriyya say
Lord
this is my message to you Alhamdulillah, this program has been conducted under the guidance of the ulama of the Ahl-e-Sunnah wa Jamaat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on the path of Ahl-e-Sunnah wa Jamaat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mothers and sisters who are present today, let me give them a message also. Mere Kareem Aqa alayhi salam ne farmaya, jahan iman hai, wahan haya hai. Jahan iman nahi, wahan haya nahi. ایمان اور حیا الگ نہیں جہاں ایک ہے دوسرا بھی ہے اللہ تعالی ہمارے ماؤں اور بہنوں کو حضرت سیدہ طیبہ طاہرہ عابدہ فاطمہ الزہرا سلام اللہ علیہا و ابیہا کا صدقہ صدیقہ کائنات معلمہ امت زوجہ رسول سیدہ عائشہ صدیقہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہا کا صدقہ ہماری ماں اور بہنوں کو شرم اور حیا کی دولت سے اللہ تعالی مال و مال فرمائے وما علینا الا البلاغ